About your album, music disc, what was the main difficult thing of its creation?
It was very hard to, because the original has already been out there quite a long time, so it was very hard to try to capture the essence of the original modules and the feel of the whole. I wanted to have some kind of tracking feel in the CD as well. So that was quite hard, because it's hard to work with. If you just use MIDI, you can't have these tracker effects done so easily, so I had to think.
You try to repeat each note of the original movie?
No. Yes, of course, that as well. I tried to make it authentic, but with better sound quality and of course to make new pieces as well, so that they would sound a bit that they could have made with a tracker. Of course, they weren't done with the tracker, but to have the tracker feel a bit, maybe. And that was my idea, and that was also very hard, because I mean, if I want to use these tracker effects, I had to program them and draw them very, very precisely, and it was quite a lot of hard work.
Software have you used?
I think I used Logic when mostly, and then I had a couple of samplers which I used quite a lot.
Is it difficult to learn Logic?
Yes, it's very. Nowadays I use Pro Tools. I have that at my home, but well, I don't know. I think every software has its pros and cons. Of course, the Logic was quite superior at MIDI back then, and we had a Mac. So the Logic was probably the only choice to use. So, but I don't know. I haven't tried the new Logic, so I don't know how it's doing now.
You use live instruments like drums, percussion.
Yes, a bit. So just to have some different sounds and stuff.
And who played guitar in most of your tracks?
This Kari Riihimäki. Kari Riihimäki, sorry.
Yes. And who is he?
He's just a friend who's a very good guitar player. They have their own band as well. So. But he's very much like a rocker. He plays rock. And so it was also him very weird playing this music.
But his guitar fits so well in your tracks.
Yes,
wonderful.
Oh, thank you. He has very good taste, and he has very good ideas. So that's also the reason why it's nice to have session musicians, because they will bring their own ideas and perspectives as well. Not just the sounds, but the licks and whatever they are doing. So it's very nice to see as well for what they are doing as well.
said that you go about to make a remake for When Heaven Falls.
Yes.
But you left this track because it sounds like the original.
Yes, I couldn't make it better, mm-hmm. So I tried. But so I just stopped. I mean, I'll just leave it as it is. So.
But will you try again a bit later? Maybe this symphony?
Well, maybe, yeah. Actually, that's a nice... Actually, I was a bit thinking about that, mm-hmm. to doing some of the remakes. I just found out about this very cheap orchestra.
Mm-hmm.
So, let's see.
It's my favorite track.
Ah, thank you.
Of all tracks.
I think it's mine as well.
Mm-hmm. Great.
I think that's probably only piece I like my own stuff.
And what's the voice sample in this track?
I don't know, I just took it from some CD. I just picked it up from somewhere. I thought it sounded cool, so I just put it there.
And what is said in this sample?
Let me think.
I can
something
find it.
I don't even know what it says. I don't think it was on the CD. I think it was something like
movies in the world when my heart goes dark.
My heart, something going dark.
Because actually it's hard to understand what she's saying.
And the funny thing is that it's not the full sentence. I took two parts from the.
Mm-hmm.
I split it up, so it's not like originally.
Therefore, I see no reason in the world why my heart grows not dark.
I don't know what it says.
Mm-hmm. But it's so beautiful.
Yeah, it's the sound of the mm-hmm. who speaks it. It's very. And they are just. I think it's pretty funny because I didn't get what she's saying.
Uh-huh.
I just heard like words.
Mm-hmm.
And it gave me this association of this piece. So. That's why I chose the sample. So it's just giving like you have a vague idea what she's saying, but not quite. I don't know. I sort of like that idea.
Kati and how?
I think Kati was. Well, we were already building our studio in Turku.
Mm-hmm.
And I was living there, and there was this pop rock at school, which I teach there little time to piano playing and such. And she was there taking singing lessons, and she was just. She came to our studio because we had a deal with this school mm-hmm. back then to record their pupils with lesser money. So she came there and she sang a couple of jazz tunes and she was really great.
Mm-hmm.
And so we asked her if we were doing this trip-hop project, which we are, by the way, we are thinking of starting to do it again. And asked her to sing in a couple of the pieces. That. So she did, and that with that one of the pieces I took part in the assembly competition.
Mm-hmm.
My friend wrote the lyrics and he's very cool. I like those lyrics a lot. It's very nice. Might be a serious hobby or hobby.
Mm-hmm.
I think she has a very nice sound in her voice. It's very nice. I hope I haven't been in touch of our Facebook friends, of course,
mm-hmm.
but I hope she keeps up the singing because there is not many people I know that has very. I mean, you can train your voice, of course, but your voice is what it is. when it's given to you. So you can make it a bit better, but if it's natural, very good sounding. So mm-hmm. it's,
I see.
It helps. She's a very nice person as well. Mm-hmm. So.
Do you have any plans about your next album?
Maybe I'll do something with the orchestra thing. That would be nice. Maybe.
With your own music?
Sorry?
With your own music?
Yes, for this kind of demo scene influenced mm-hmm. somehow. I don't know how to make it yet. Maybe to use a tracker and a symphonic orchestra or something, other insane idea. I don't know. I haven't thought about it too much, but I have had a lot of ideas, but usually they end up not to do, because it always takes years mm-hmm. to do some project, and it takes a lot of effort, so the idea has to be really cool and very, very good idea to make it. Mm-hmm. Because of course, I would not get too much money out of it, so I would just be...
For fun.
For fun, yes. And it's big stretches if you do something for fun for years. And sometimes when you're working, it's not fun, mm-hmm. it's work. And other days it's fun, and other days it's not fun. So, well, but let's see, maybe someday.
I hope so. The track Mosaic Days is my favorite track.
Thanks.
It's very melancholic, but the vocals is positive.
Yes.
The lyrics. When and why have you wrote it?
Well, I always liked Massive Attack and Politician and these kind of very darkish the sounds of the music. I just like that music a lot. So mm-hmm. we wanted to do something that we would be able to go out gigging in small clubs or something. I just wanted to do this project and we started to work it. So that's why.
And years ago you wrote a track for 3D Mark.
No, this is actually done by Captain, you know.
But not by you?
No, not by me. There is more parts in this.
The second part, when the guy like Neo from Matrix.
Yeah, that's mine.
It's your track.
Yeah, yes.
I didn't know. Do you play guitar?
No. Well, I can play something when I've had too much beer and maybe on a campfire. Mm-hmm. Then I can play Kumbaya or something, but mm-hmm. not like anything serious.
And about your studio, how you made it? How you built it?
With blood. All the money I got, I put it back on the studio for like the last 10 years. Now it's sort of finished, so I'm not. I have a bit more money to go to beer as well and mm-hmm. to movies. But I think it's. Well, we still. I think we have to move to a better location, a better space to have it, because it's getting too small. But it's been taking a lot of time. I think gradually over 10 years, I think.
I see.
We have this sound engineer guy as well. Mm-hmm. We are both running the studio, mm-hmm. and he's a very good guitarist. He's Timo Hanpää. I don't know if you heard about him, but he's played a lot of guitars for different. Mm-hmm. I think he's actually playing on the Matrix part. He's playing the guitars on it as well. So. I just did all the programming and other stuff.
One guy asks you about the stuff on the studio, microphones, monitors.
I knew this would come up. Well, we have a couple of Genelec monitors. This 1032, I think. Yes, and then this... okay. Actually, you can see all our stuff in our website. We did a new website, so there is a lot of stuff there. I just bought this very classic Neve 1084 channel and Wunder Audio CM7 microphone. They are very good combination. I've been liking it a lot, so which is not on the website listed, but there is more stuff on our studio, but we just put the main interesting stuff there. To see. But I think the equipment is okay. I think we just need a better space now to record.
Мы подходим к владениям Йонни Валтонена. За этой дверью находится двор чистый. И там дверь в его подъезд. А мы точно зайдем?
Куда?
Нам туда, назад, в музей.
Ну, по пешке.
Ну, давай. Песня пива, конечно, есть.
Против дома великого человека.
Я.
I have my computer still. Making noise.
I see.
Last summer. So it's sort of newish. And yeah, there was a lot of
computers. Now digital.
Yeah. And then there's the inbox 3. So. Yeah, the printer and lab
candles
and all kinds of crap.
Oh. And how you connect the computer?
It's just USB cable and a very long
VGA?
Yeah, cables.
I see.
It's nice, they are not making any noise, so it's totally quiet.
It's for a long tracker.
Yeah, I'll show you. I am using Sibelius program for this. Yeah, sorry. It's a bit... Yeah, my view is quite nice. There isn't any view. Well, this is very strange place anyway, because it's built so early, so there is a lot of weird stuff here. So because why I need this is that, I mean, if I'd have normal screen, I mean, I would have to scroll up and down all the time. This is the active score. So when I put it here, I can see everything right away.
What do you use a mixer for?
Mix. I don't mix anything. It's just. All the synthesizers are in.
The volume.
Yeah. Oh, this is the guy who are asking about my stuff. This is what I have at my home. This is a Fred Forsell. This is a very clean preamp, which is cool for live. I mean, this kind of clear sound. And then I have this Neve preamp, which is cool. Then I have some processors here, which I use. I totally love this analog synthesizer. This Studio Electronics ATCX thing, and of course I have a lot of soft instruments and others and all kinds of crap. I only know this.
What instrument are you wondering of?
Sorry, what instrument?
What instrument do you like to buy or
buy? Ah,
to play.
I played a harp for 3 years in our school. I studied, played it with a teacher to know it a bit better because it's hard to write for it. So I wanted to play it a bit to understand how it works. And of course I have piano and I want new keyboards all the time, of course. I've been checking if I'd get this Moog Voyager, the monophonic synthesizer. I've been trying to get that.
And you have your own harp?
No, I don't. I mean, they cost a lot to get. But in our conservatory there is one harp, so I can go and play there if I want to.
Nice.
But the piano is my main instrument. So.
Couldn't imagine in the beginning of 19th that you will work with orchestra.
No. Of course, it's been always my dream, but because writing for an orchestra is quite hard, actually. Mm-hmm. There's so much variables you have to take into account, and so that you are getting the result you want. So, and back then I didn't know how to start studying and how to. I mean, I applied to Sibelius Academy, but I didn't get there. Which is okay. I mean, I like this school very much here. I got here. So later I applied again. So I got here. It's more oriented on modern music, very, very much so.
And can you play it or just notes?
Yeah, I can play it. This is the new fanfare for this Symphonic Legends, which is coming now. So, I have actual version here as well, so. It plays it like that, but I can play it from here. They recorded it in Köln, I think last couple of weeks ago, so. This is the same. This is how it's sounding from with a real orchestra. This is the opening fanfare for them, so it has to be fanfaric. I think you can listen on the YouTube as well. I think it's there already. Excellent conductor, by the way. You can see they are playing it. I've been writing these arrangements for this. They are releasing a piano versions of different Square Enix music as well. I think there's some other stuff as well, like stuff from Nobuo Uematsu is composing one extra piece for it, and it's going to be quite cool CD.
I'm arranging some pieces for the piano for this pianist. Actually, the guy who played this symphonic legends last year on the piano part for this.
What's his name?
Benjamin Nuss.
But anyway, yes, I would not thought about it.
What other game composers do you like?
Game composers? Inon Suur, of course. I like him.
Who?
Inon Suur, you know, that guy who did for Fallout 3 and Dragon
Age. I see. Yes.
I just found out about this Marco Beltrami guy, but he's working for movies. Mm-hmm. He's doing music for movies. I've been listening to him a lot.
What time you prefer to work, day or night?
Day and night.
Uh-huh.
I think I work all the time.
And what's your working day? What it looks like?
I wake up, I put some coffee on, and then I read the newspaper, then I just start working.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, if I'll continue something I've done earlier, day before
mm-hmm.
that day, and I'll just continue it. It's easier to continue something. I've noticed that I start a new thing every night, so that when I woke up and when I start working, I already sort of have done it a bit, mm-hmm. so that it doesn't feel like I have to start everything from zero.
Mm-hmm.
I've noticed it's easier. I get to work mode much faster that way, anyways. But so I start working, and then I work something like till 12, and then I eat, and then I work till 4. And if there's a lot of pressure to do something, then I just keep working.
Mm-hmm. Every day.
Yeah, but if I don't have any big project going on, then I'll take the rest of the day off and go to movies or something, see my friends or go fishing.
It's interesting.
Well, this is basically what I do every day, all the time.
And once again, how it became so cool and popular?
Actually, I think I was, I just got really lucky. That's the biggest thing. It could have been anybody. I just met PSI,
mm-hmm.
and I think it was mostly chance and luck, mostly. I think in life, a lot of things are a lot to do with chance. I mean, you have to be good enough on a situation, and when this kind of opportunity comes, then you have to take it. And then it might lead to something cool or not. But I'm glad that you considered that mm-hmm. it led to something cool. I think I probably would have worked and composed anyway, so. But maybe that, like that.
Great. Many guys asked me to say thank you to you because you changed their lives affected to the stuff they're doing.
Oh, thank you. This is very hard for me to hear.
Great. Thank you so much for the interview.
Thank you very much. And thank you for this present. Total fantastic present.